Okay, so it is time for breakfast, and I'm gonna have some oatmeal, my favorite oatmeal. I'm not sure if I've shared this before. I think I have in a shorts video, and it's just banana walnut oatmeal with some raisins in it. It is pure perfection. So that's what I am gonna have. I'll sit. So I'm gonna weigh because I need to track what I'm eating. All right, so I got my bowl. Here we go. I'm gonna log it into my chronometer, my food tracker. Oh my gosh, come on. I'm gonna do 40 grams of quick oats because I am gonna make this in the microwave. Yes, I'm gonna make it in the microwave. I know that some people may not be a big fan of the microwave, but I am. It comes in handy, it's convenient, it makes my life a lot easier. So I'm sticking with that. I'm gonna add in some cinnamon to spice it up, cinnamon to taste, and then I'm gonna add in 2 packs of stevia because I'm a sweethead. And I just love sweets. A few. All right. Now I'm gonna add in half of a banana. Let me get a knife. Okay, all right. I think we're right there. All right, that's about half. Doesn't have to be perfect. We're gonna slice it. So let's see. Now I'm gonna add in about 6 fluid ounces of milk, great source of calcium. I'm using soy milk because it's higher in protein and I love the creaminess of it. I'm gonna save a little bit of this for later. So now I'm gonna stir it and pop it in the microwave. Oatmeal is done. This is what our oatmeal looks like. Whoa, it's smoky. Let's turn this on. Okay, so I usually don't like to add too much protein powder because sometimes it kind of warps the taste for me. But this doesn't seem like it's done enough. I'm gonna put it in the microwave for a little bit more. It's not done. Let me watch this because it might spill. So now I think we are good. Looks a lot thicker and like it's cooked. I'm gonna add just like 20 grams of protein, and then I'll probably have a little bit more protein on the side because I don't want to kill my oatmeal with protein. Just ends up not tasting it great. This is where we add in some more milk. Now we're gonna mix again. Now I'm gonna add in the last of my walnuts. I don't have very many left. Usually don't do too much on the walnuts. Oh, forget it. It's not that much. And then I'm gonna add just a little box of raisins. So we are ready to eat. I have some protein powder in here with water just to break up the amount of protein for my oatmeal because I didn't want to dry out my oatmeal with protein. So I'm gonna take my vitamins. Multivitamin. algae oil for omega 3 and then my vitamin D3 sup. So I'm gonna take these. All right, and I also need to take my B12 sup, so I'm gonna grab that in a moment. Cheers to the B12 sup. I gotta swish it around. I really like the walnuts inside of my oatmeal. It's a good source of omega 3 and it adds a nice little crunch. This is like my favorite thing. Okay, so I'm gonna finish eating this and I will see you afterwards. Okay, so while my food digests, I like to wait about an hour to an hour and a half, 2 hours. Well, let me backtrack. I like to wait at least an hour and a half after I eat a meal to go and workout train. So while I'm kind of letting my stomach settle, or just in the meantime, whatever, I'm going to prep some of my food for later on today. So I didn't finish cooking some of my meals. So yesterday I had kind of pre-prepped, and then today I'm going to finish off because I know I may not have time later on. And like one thing that I've learned is that I don't like to wait till I get really, really hungry. Like that's kind of a death trap, at least for me, because if I let my hunger pains or like my hunger level drop below a certain amount, I'll literally just start snacking on things, and usually it's things that I shouldn't eat, or I'll overconsume. So to avoid that, I like to try to make sure I have meals prepared and ready to go so that I don't run into that issue. So I have some rice here, white rice, jasmine rice, and I'm going to cook that in a rice cooker. So that's the first thing I'm going to prep. All right, rice is cooking, and now I'm going to prep some Brussels sprouts. I am going to bake them. I'm going to chop these up and throw a little bit of oil on them and then season them and then bake them. I got a bag for compost and now we're ready to chop. So whenever I cut these up, sometimes I do them just in halves. Well, actually I'll do some in halves and then some in fourths. So these are the halves. I'll toss them in the bowl. And these are the fourths. Sometimes I'll do thirds too. So I'll maybe cut it in half and then do one side, just one side, so I end up like this, like that. I don't know, I just like playing around with the different sizes. All personal preference. Okay. Ooh-ooh. Saving the scraps for compost. Thank you.
so I just made it to the gym, and I've never been to this gym, so I'm excited. If I'm not feeling it, I'm gonna leave. So I'm just gonna get a one day pass, try it out, see how I like it. But if I walk in and I'm not feeling it, then I'm just gonna go to my original gym. So yeah. All right, so I need to pee. I need to use the bathroom, so I'm not gonna talk too long. I'm excited to go in, so bye. Inside the gym. I am done at the gym. I was gonna drink my protein powder. It literally spilled all in my bag. There's still some protein powder in here. I just don't know how much is left. Shake, 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 shake. All right. It's like 5 o'clock and it's already getting dark, but I'm gonna drink this now because my body needs it. And then when I get home, I need to clean out my bag. All right, I'm back from the gym and I'm getting ready to eat lunch. Actually feels like I'm getting ready to eat dinner because it's dark outside. 6 o'clock, a late lunch, but still gonna get in the calories. All right, so I'm gonna have some lentil soup and rice and I'm gonna weigh it out. Okay, so it is dinner time and I'm having some baked tofu in Brussels sprouts. I added a little bit of garlic and herb sauce on top of the Brussels sprouts. Even my tofu is flavored garlic and herb, but that's... Oh, that's what it looks like, the tofu. Honestly, one of my favorite things to eat. And then for a little bit of dessert, I'm having half an apple. I've already been into it. Green apples. Oh my gosh. Green apples are like the bestest. I actually made an apple pie for Thanksgiving, made with Granny Smith apples, and it was bomb. I wish I could eat that every day. My mom helped me with it. It came out delicious, to say the least. I know I'm like on a fat loss journey, and the goal is honestly, like, the ultimate goal is to focus on nourishment and feeding my body the proper amount of food and the right foods, right? Like whole foods, nutrient dense foods, being consistent. Cause I'm not that consistent. Honestly, that's where I struggle with my eating. I'm gonna be honest with that. Like, there are times where I am like good with my eating, and then there are times where I'm just not so good. So that's a part of like the whole fitness thing, is that it's not gonna be perfect. There are gonna be ups and downs. I tracked my food all today so I can go over my calories. So I'm at around a little under 1700 calories, 1675 to be, I guess, more precise. I didn't hit the 140 grams of protein. It's all right. It's all right. I'm right under 130. That's because I spilled some of the, I had to subtract some of the protein powder that fell out of my shaker, and I didn't re-up or like
replace that whenever I came home, and I kind of guesstimated and subtracted some of that out. So I was at like 135 grams, but with some of the protein powder that spilled in my gym bag, I just kind of subtracted as best as I could from eyeballing things. So that put me at like 129 grams, but it's all right. I'm at 196 grams of carbs and 47 grams of fat. And it was all good stuff. I'm gonna eat and go to sleep because I need to. My goal is to like get up at 5, and I have not done that. So I gotta go sleep on time. All right, I love you guys, and I'll see you next video.